What's up, everybody? I'm Adam Macias. This is That Was Wild, and tonight's show is going to be wild. Whoa, yes. When I say that was, you say wild. That was. That's not wild enough. That was. Oh, my gosh. I have had too many fucking Red Bulls. Oh, my gosh. You guys are already so freaking amazing. If you've never been to this show before, we have some of the most wildest comedians in L.A., nay, the world, do their best stand-up comedy. And then we have, yes. Who said yes? Yes. You know it. I love it. And then we have some amazing improvisers do this thing called improv comedy. It's a little mick-em-ups. Little mick-em-ups on the spot based off of the stand-up set. It's going to be wild. That was... Okay, you guys got to be quicker on the draw there. Wild. Oh, I love it. Ooh, I love it. That was, oh, I fucking love you guys. You guys are already freaking amazing. We have an amazing set tonight. You guys already know the deal. There's bathrooms in the back. There's drinks right there. I'm a comic. I'm going to do some time. So let's get fucking wild. Oh, yeah. Speaking of comics, I went to Sacramento recently to go see the Bad Friends live comedy show. They got Andrew Santino, Bobby Lee, yes. Why did I go to Sacramento to do that when they live in L.A.? because I hate the Comedy Store. Don't tell them I said that. it was a birthday present for my brother, and so we went together because I do this thing where I've decided to give my brother a Christmas present that I'll also enjoy because he's terrible at giving me gifts. This year's Christmas gift, guess what? I thought about you all year. This was in my Amazon cart all year. And I just had to get it for you. I saw you, I was like, I had to get it for you. What do you think it was, sir? It was a keychain. You're not my brother, Felipe. Don't start that narrative. My brother's in the back. No, it was a keychain, and I was like, okay, cool. I'm buying my own gifts now. So it was Bad Friends. And so here's the wild part. I was there in the Southwest Terminal, and the cast was on the plane with me. Bobby Lee, Andrew Santino. It's a really weird experience traveling with the performers you're going to go see. Because it's like, the best you could do with Southwest, you know? It's like, where's my $35 nacho money going to? Not first class, that's for sure. It's a weird experience. I've never traveled with that. It's like, it kind of takes the magic out of it a little bit, you know? It's like seeing Bono on the bus on the way to a show. Taking a rickshaw with Lady Gaga. An Uber pool with Beyonce. A helicopter ride with Kobe Bryant. Okay, anyways. That's a different situation. No, it's really weird. No, I did feel safe, actually. I was like, oh, the celebrities are here? This plane is not going down. There's no way. They're at the peak of their career. I was like, it was like one of those moments where I was like, okay, celebrities on this plane. If you've ever flown with a celebrity, or something like that, it's like, either flight is going to go completely normal, or I'll not be mentioned in tomorrow's top story. that's what it was. It was totally fine. The show was great. I did fly Southwest. Anybody, any other madmen out there that fly Southwest as well? Oh, yes, you guys are fucking wild. I love it. Fucking unhinged people. That's what I love about Southwest is that it's like, you know how most airlines are based off of like a tier system? Like if it was a concert venue, there's like the nosebleeds, and then there's the box seats. That's all other airlines. Well, we're like, well, fuck that. Southwest is just the fucking mosh pit. That's what Southwest is. It's fucking Hunger Games. Winner takes all, motherfucker. It's insane. It's insane. Yes, here's a tip. Actually, This is what I love about Southwest, is that like no matter where you show up, you could still sit up in the front row, which is just amazing, you know? I've definitely been like, I'm showing up 10 minutes before this flight with a Walgreens trash bag for my fucking luggage, throw that in the overset. It was like, oh shit, there's a middle seat open. That's a trick, that's the trick. No one wants to sit in the middle seat. They'd rather sit near the toilet in the back than sit in someone's middle seat. But let's be honest. If you're on a Southwest flight, the only thing you really want is to get off the fucking plane. That's all you want. So that's why, here's a tip, just go for the middle seat. And I've definitely done that. Fucking boarding group C, last person in line. Oh, look at that. Front row. Guess who's getting off the flight first, motherfuckers? The looks that I get. Oh, the looks that I get. It's like, where's your money now, motherfucker? Sitting next to him. Oh, my gosh. Where's your money now? That's democracy. That's what that is. No, Southwest is absolutely insane. It's an insane. This is my Southwest chunk, guys. What's the deal with Southwest? Okay. No, but seriously, what the fuck is the deal with Southwest? I went there and somebody was just dragging a box through the terminal as their luggage. A cardboard box. A cardboard box. Imagine that. Oh, just dragging it by its open flats. It wasn't even closed. I could see their underwear. I was like, what is happening? Is no one going to stop this? I can't even bring a toenail clipper. What the fuck? No, but this was actually pretty wild. I flew back on February 29th, which is, of course, leap day, right? Leap day. Any leap day babies out here? Okay, cool. They're quiet. They all actually don't exist after 29th. They just zip away. No, it's the February 29th. So at the terminal, all at Southwest in San Francisco, back to LA, they were like, you know what would be cool today? You know how most people are just like chill at the terminal where people are waiting for the seats? Yeah, let's do a fucking game show. That's what they did. They were like, guess what? Why we do leap years? They were asking all of the people on the flight to do like trivia about the leap year, why we do this. And I don't remember any of them because I was pissed and I had my headphones on. And I'm not going to quiz you on that at all tonight. I think it has to do with like hours, every 6 hours. I don't know. Anyways, Google it. Somebody Google it for it. Felipe, my brother, Google it. So they started doing this thing and it's just annoying. They're doing like searches and scratch and sniffs and I don't know what the fuck's going on. And all of a sudden, they're like, well, guess what? Under everybody's chair is a golden frog. And the person that finds that gets $500 off their Southwest flight. So not under everyone's chair, under someone's chair. No, that would be wild. Under someone's chair. And when I tell you the chaos that it brought, because people were like, what the fuck, Southwest, let's go. And there was a women's soccer team, like the sequel to Yellow Jackets, just being like, Kennedy, you go on that side, all right? Jackson, this side, we got this clear, you know? Like they were checking it out. It was absolute chaos. And I'm just steaming, pissed, editing a podcast, you know, also because I'm editing a podcast and I'm editing this and I'm mad. Okay, not people actually think it's cool that I had a podcast apparently. Okay. So I was like, I'm not getting up. I'm not getting up. And they can't find it. This is going on way too long. Just like this set. It's going way too long. They're like, oh, what's going on? Where's it? And I'm just like, I'm not looking. And I'm like, it's under my seat. I know it's under my seat. I'm not going to look. Oh, I know. Oh, somebody else found it. Okay. I'm not special. It was a nice older lady who spent $500 to travel to see their fam. It was you. It was you. So anyways, I was like, I'm not significant. I'm probably going to fly a helicopter with Kobe Bryant after this. I'm going to take it down further. But then I'm going to bring it up because underneath every one of your seats is a fucking ticket. Check under it. Go. Go. If there's a ticket under your seat, swear to God, why aren't you getting up? What the fuck? There's a check under your seat. I'm seriously, check under your fucking seat. Check, there's a seat. Look, there's tickets underneath your seat. Except for you guys, you're part of the show. Okay, so there's two things. There's a ticket, you guys get tickets. All right? I swear to God, there's fucking tickets underneath your seats. All right? And at the end of the show, there's a raffle, and you actually get a gift, okay? Yes, you guys get a fucking gift, except for you guys, because you're the performers. Okay. Okay, so either they're mad at me, Molly, or they're happy. okay, you guys ready? Okay, so that was wild. Okay, so hold on to those tickets. Happy New Year. I don't know what that's from. I think I might be from another show. hold on to those. I'll announce the winners a little bit later. All right, everybody ready? Here we go. All right. All right, the numbers are 520 44 8 4. That's you. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my wife. She won. I swear to God that didn't land it. You won a $50 Southwest gift card. Congratulations. Everybody, thank you so much for coming out. We have another That Was Wild on March 16th at the Yard, so please check that out. Again, thank you so much for coming out. Stay wild, because let's say it one more time. 1, 2, 3. That was wild! Thank you so much, everybody.